thank you very much for coming in. You Thanks are a busy me. Boy now.
Yeah, I am.
You
I
and
it.
Peggy, you rule Hollywood.
Yeah, I guess.
And how's life? You well?
I am well. My life is very good. I'm working. I'm happy.
You sound like one of those terrorist videos when someone's been held against. I'm being fed.
No, it's underpaid. Fine.
Al Jazeera live.
It's fine. It's fine. I'm fine. Help me. Send money.
And so you go. This is amazing. You're in Martin Amis's adaptation of Money, which was out in the 80s. And I've read, which is a good book, about all the greed in the 80s. But now, 2010, what's gone on the last sort of 18 months, 2 years, with the collapse of the banks?
Fat
and all
cats.
I beg your pardon?
Fat cats.
Thank you. I like that little phrase there. It feels really timely.
Yeah, absolutely. Well, it's all cyclical, isn't it? It all comes round again. And here it is. We're gripped by greed once again, Christian.
You've tuned into Radio 4. Good morning. My special guest this morning, talking about the economic crisis. Forget old Robert Peston. You've got a new Peston.
Yeah.
I tell you, if Clegg and Cameron sort the country out, Peston's out of work, isn't he? Because you never saw him before this crisis. I'm not saying he's single-handedly responsible for it and he's done something to create this, but I'm just asking a question, Nick.
Yeah? I think as a journalist, it's a question you need to ask.
You just promoted me to a journalist.
Well, I think you are, aren't you?
From a DJ who played the same song twice, back to back.
Yeah. I didn't say you were a good journalist. I just... do you prefer the moniker broadcaster?
I think, yeah, it's more than DJ. You kind of think of some idiot who just tells the time out loud. Yeah. Which is what I do, basically.
What are you looking at me? No. You haven't even got the phone number up in the office.
And so, was it good fun doing this? It's all set in the 80s. Was it good fun putting on the 80s gear again and the Sergio Tacchini tops?
There was no. I mean, it's not, we didn't reshoot The Firm. It's, I think the thing about 80s is if you've got a great costume designer, and we did have a good costume designer, you don't notice it's the 80s, because otherwise it is just, you know, everyone wearing Lyle and Scott roll necks and, you know, Pringle V-necks underneath. I mean, it wasn't like that. Do you know what I mean?
Well, people get aggressive. I was.
Well, why?
Why is it cocky?
I'm angry about it.
Russell Crowe here.
What do you mean, Irish?
Yes, and it was. You've made him an Irish character in your adaptation of it. So it didn't. Although it's set in the 80s, that's more the backdrop of what was going on with money and stuff like that.
Any day that I'm on a set with my friend Jeremy Lovering, who directed it, it's fun. It's fun to be on a set. The crew was amazing. They put a lot of effort in, and you know, we shot a 2-hour film in 4 weeks, which is really quite difficult. So it was hard to do, and it was hard to be John Self all the time.
He's quite a, I think, hedonistic, greedy prostitute. He's into prostitutes, into pornography. Mm-hmm. Typecast or
Scotch? Well, you know, we've all been there, haven't we, Christian? You know, we've all locked ourselves in a cheap hotel with a crate of brown liquor and seen where it's taken us.
And Jerry Hall's in this as well.
She is, yeah.
She good?
She's lovely. She was very good, and she is a lovely woman. I was quite terrified of her at first, obviously, because she's a very tall, beautiful, powerful woman, and she was a real sweetheart. I think she's slightly disappointed that I haven't contacted her to walk the dogs. That is an invite that keeps coming in.
Sounds like a euphemism.
Walking the dogs?
Walk the dogs, yeah. Have you got any dogs, or just a phrase?
I do have a dog.
Yeah, what you got?
I got a little border terrier, and he's a treat, I tell you.
I would have thought a big guy like you, more a Labrador man.
No, I don't. I'm not a fan of the Labrador.
You don't like? Who doesn't like Labradors?
Me, I mean, they're all right, but I wouldn't choose to have one.
Really?
Yeah.
You're going for a little sort of yappy sort of
dog.
He's
not yappy.
He's not yappy.
You watch it, mate. No, he's lovely. I mean, he's lovely. He's like a magical Disney hound.
And so what else, because you and Simon seriously do so much stuff now, are we allowed to talk about Tintin and when's that out?
I think we can talk about Tintin. I'm not sure. I think late next year. There's obviously a lot to do on it, so they're working away very... very busily in New Zealand and LA.
Could you believe that you go for the sort of, you know, being Peggy's friend, you do Space Together, which is one of the most underrated comedies of the 90s. Space is a fantastic
thing.
You
mean thing, underrated?
Right? Well, it is. I never thought it got the just deserve it should have done. If you did something like that now, but at the time, you know, I watched and it was fantastic. It was way ahead of the curve. You know, and if it came out now, you'd have BAFTAs, you'd get awards and stuff like that, which it never got at the time. It was like a kind of cult hit.
Well, yeah, we're comedy's great nearly, men.
Oh, yeah. He says with, what, you're working with Steven Spielberg?
No, I'm in terms of awards, that's all.
Yeah.
I'm not bitter.
And was it good fun working with Spielberg?
It was amazing. It was amazing. It was terrifying, but it was amazing. You know, it's he directed kind of all my favourite films, and to see him, you know, he's very tactile and he likes to get amongst it, and he operates the camera a lot himself. And, you know, I don't know what I expected. I imagine that he'd kind of be sitting above the arena in a floating silver orb. But he was just like a director. It was great.
How weird is that? You go, suddenly you've been directed by Steven Spielberg, one of the greatest directors ever.
He likes to tell a story too. So Close Encounters is my favourite film. So he just, if you poke him slightly, he just comes out and just tells stories about Close Encounters. It's amazing.
Fantastic. Yeah. And what was he? Was he friendly? Does he ever get angry? Because it must be tense trying to make something like that. All the money involved and egos.
He was absolutely lovely. He was lovely. He was a director. He came, he directed you, he said, I'd like you to do this. And then if you did a good take, he'd come and say, that's great. That's in the movie. That's great. And it was great.
Did you nick anything from the set? As a little memento? Yeah, I'm with Spielberg.
One of the cameras. Tintin. I got one of the big cameras.
Just put it under a blanket.
$200,000.
Yeah, just out the door. Just
I can't
hide it
use
away.
It. Yeah, it's the wrong format. But
it's in the front garden.
I got
right
him
now,
to sign it. I'll tell you what. Years ago, when I was like 19 or 20, I used to trawl secondhand shops looking for first edition books, and I found at the time a first edition novelization of Close Encounters written by Spielberg.
Wow.
And I'd had it for years and years, and I thought, I am going to get him to sign it. And he signed it, and he's put a lovely, lovely personal, you know, whatever that word is.
Personal message?
Message, yeah.
How much are you going to get for that on eBay?
Oh, yeah, I mean, countless. It's like, it's up to 60 like, quid.
Oh, Nick, I'll sign it to you. No, don't worry about that. Just put, put to eBay 510513.
No, don't personalise it. I'll never sell it.